almost every beginner do this mistake, where inner parts, the lining parts, are shown through the upper. Well, not on my shoes, but on your shoes. So if you want to avoid it, watch this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So let's do it. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. Although in this tutorial I will talk about underlines made in lining pattern, this approach will be suitable in making uppers as well, where you have underlines. I will talk about lining pattern because, as I said in the beginning, is one of the most common mistakes that beginners do, where you can see the underline of your lining through the upper, and it's very bad. So now you will learn how to avoid it. I have here an example of lining pattern of high heels pumps, and it consists of three parts, and I have many underlines here. So what is underline? Underline is the place where two parts of our upper or two parts of our lining are attached together, like this one. One part on top of other part, and this is the mark of underline. It lays under one of the pieces, in this case under this piece, and the mark of underline we have on one side, other side of the part doesn't have any mark. And we need to attach it like this here, and then this part of our back, part of our heel, and it goes here, it will be attached under this piece, and we have underline on this part on one side and then on the other side. So following these lines we will know where to attach second piece of our lining, because we will have the mark. So why we have extended places on the upper? Why lining extends? Why we see the edge of the lining through the upper? The main reason is that you don't skive well, or skive only on one part. It's a rule in shoemaking and pattern making that we should skive every place where we have underline. And we have underline on this part of our lining, the marks of underline here. So we need to skive this part until the mark. And this is how we'll reduce the amount of leather, reduce the thickness of leather, but it's not enough. We should also skive second part of our lining as well, a little bit. So that's why this is how we will create smooth transition between two parts. It depends on the thickness of your lining. If you have a very thick lining, you should skive second part as well. If you have not so thick lining, like 1 millimeter, you can leave it without skiving. But when I make shoes, I want to be sure that nothing will not extend through the upper, so I skive just a little bit the edge of the second part as well. So let's do it. I took two pieces, it's not the exact pattern that I have, but to demonstrate it, how to work, it's enough. How it's work, it's enough. So here I just will mark the underline, and I need to have this pencil here, see? The underline, and here will be, let's make it here. Let's make underline in this place. It just, you see, this lays exactly along the edge of the upper of the lining to make this underline parallel to this line. And that's why I use this pattern. So here I have the underline, and then will be attached second piece. So we need to skive. and we should scarf it almost until the line, until the mark that we have on the lining. If you will scarf beyond this line, behind this line, you will ruin a little bit your lining because the scarving will be visible. So if you are not sure in your scarving possibilities, turn over your lining and scarf on the inner side. So I will scarf here and then I will show how to do it on the top side of the lining. So scarf in the distance of almost 7-8 millimeters, not 8 is the underline, is 7-6 millimeters the distance between line and the edge. Here, because I scarfed on the inner side, you can even scarf more than 8 millimeters if you are not so experienced shoemaker, if you just started to make shoes. If you will scarf on the top side, you should be very precise to not go behind the mark. So we start from the edge. I will scarf just a little bit the edge, and then I will hold here with the, I will hold the lining pattern with this finger, and then scarf with the beginning of the blade, and make sure that the blade doesn't touch the mark. Okay, you see, now I scarfed on the top side and I reduced the amount, the thickness of leather. And when I will attach here the upper, the second part, I will have a small step here. I will see this edge. And that's why now to reduce it, to make flat surface, to make smooth transition between one side and second side, I will scarf this edge a little bit, and I will scarf it on the inner side of the lining leather. Don't scarf too much to not reduce the strength of these two parts attached together. So scarf just a little bit in the distance of 2 millimeters, scarf the edge, then hold with your fingers the edge that you already scarfed, and scarf in the distance of 2 millimeters just to reduce thickness of the edge. And then when you will attach here, you will not feel here nothing. So let's attach it and we'll hammer it, so you will see how it will come out. Now let's place glue on both parts. Glue place until the mark. Don't pass the mark. Do not make dirty the other part of your lining. And also place glue on the second part on the inner side. Now let's wait 10-15 minutes until it will dry. Now you can attach two pieces together. Attach this edge exactly to the mark that you have on the second part. You should cover it. If you made, of course, the button like this, attach, and then you can hammer it. Now you see, I have here right now smooth transition between two parts, and this edge will not extend for the upper. Some brands even don't sew in this place in the back seam here. Sometimes I also don't sew, but to have to be sure that during lasting your lining will not open, in the beginning of your shoemaking craft, sew here in the back part and make underline like this. So at the end, when you were last your lining, your upper, you will have beautiful upper without any extending places. Okay, so thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.